And our theme tonight is looking back so we can look forward. And Roger is going to speak at this time and introduce our evening speakers.
Yeah, actually what I'm going to do is just basically introduce Jack and Harold Kassner. How many here belong to the Montague Museum? Okay, how many have been there in the last year or two? Yeah, okay. Good stuff, good stuff. Anyway, I look at Jack and say it's kind of in the gene pool, because basically his father was one of the people of the originators of the Montague Museum. And so Jack just comes by naturally, and somehow through Wendell, whatever name you want to put on it, Jack, local person, knows a lot about that. The other person, Harold Kassner, who's going to help him tonight, also local, lots of good stories, very active in the Montague Museum. Jim Haley is here somewhere too. He's also very active in the Montague Museum. And so it's a wonderful collection, and it's the building's owned by the city of Montague. And actually, we've had a meeting there periodically, but maybe it's time to dust off the Montague Museum again, also as a program. But just a good good source of information, wonderful photographs. And also, they're always looking for someone to take a shift between 1 and 5. And we have a meeting early in the spring when you're to do your shift. And I always say, if you don't take a shift, they're very quiet. They burn your house down. So you have to take a shift. But anyway, what's fun is that, like, if you're there, you get to somehow snoop around, and there's great snooping. I was there one day, 2 years ago, and this guy walks in. He said, "I'm Edward Ferry." I said, "Of the Ferry family?" He said, "Yes." And it was Edward P. Ferry III. And we had a great time. Asked him where he lived. He said, "California." Where? He said, "Mill Valley." You know, just in the next block. Anyway, great story. And so come on by the Montague Museum. They need your help. And Jack, Harold, let's go.
Well, we got to say one thing. Jack came into it naturally because his dad said we got to move something to be here. Okay.
When you see what they did.
Boys, coffee here.
This is the water wagon. They iced the tracks. They graded in tracks and they iced them when they were hauling big loads of logs to the rollaway.
And the kitchen boys put dust on the track where it goes downhill, so they went. The horses went get bumped.
That's how they loaded them on the sleighs. There's the ice wagon, that's a scraper. This is one of the...
This is a coal train set up there in their barns just off the new era. Bolted up there.
This was the accident of the Colville train up by New Era, which is up just north of Rochdale on Sand Creek up there. This is the rollaway down at the river. This is the swampers. They worked all the way down the river, in the water, on the logs, keeping everything moving. This is Lloyd's Landing down there, the first settlement, the mouth. That's when the ferries had the first steam mill down there. They cut all the logs. You can see them in the pond there, but then they soon run out of logs. This was a ferry's mill down there at the mouth. That's down at the bottom of the hill before you get to Old Channel Inn. This is another picture down there at the mouth. This is the boarding house. Was down here at Mears, Lion's Den. this is view of Montague from up by, well, where Jim Rose's corner is, William Street and stuff.
Looking downtown.
Downtown. Here's the old sweet store, Nesbitt store. There's the Montague Inn, or it could be the King Building. This is the Dowling's Mill, the Red Mill. There's other ones in here. That's from down in the slip. This is Dowling's Mill right down there. You'd see this is the bridge to Whitehall, where the Montague Campground and the White Lake Insurance is. That was all just water. That's where they stored their logs. Then they run them in here, sawed them, and then loaded them out to the boats. This is Frank White's Mill. That's down kind of where the launch ramp is, and the band shell. You can see the church up in the background. That was a big mill. This is Ferry and Dowling's Shingle Mill. That's right on the river where the Dog and Suds is now. And for years I wonder how they took the next few pictures, but looking at the roof or these windows is probably what they use. This is looking from the top of that building out to the lake. This is all lumber on those pilings out on the Whitehall side there from Colville's Mill. There's a tramway right here that run all the way into the mill. Somebody came through with a load of hay. The guys at the mill had to go out with their pike poles and push up part of the tramway so they could get through.
What kind of a bridge is that?
Swinging.
That's a swing bridge.
By hand.
They put a big key in the middle of it, and guys, four, five, six of them, get out there and walk around, turn the bridge. I heard that this bridge, when they took it up to the county line bridge. Okay. Now this is looking out the other end of that building.
That's the boom dock.
That's the boom house and the railroad bridge. There's all, that's all logs and stuff in the booms up there to be sorted. There's another. That's looking up the river from the railroad bridge now.
Now that's after they straightened the river.
They straightened the river, yes. And why I'm interested in this stuff is that's my grandpa standing right there. This is a cobble mill. It's on the Whitehall side of the bridge.
Jack mentioned the fire prevention barrel.
Oh, yeah. Just went up there if you had a fire with an axe and chopped a hole in it. But you can see the boom house in the back, the road's right here. Here's that tramway across where they rolled the lumber out. And right here is where they opened it up if they had a high load going through. This is the Charmer Mill down below the hill. Heald, Crepin, and Murphy. Down by Bartow Boat Works. They sawed a lot of lumber in that mill because they had gang saws. This is a coal dock out here. This would be where the marine is right now, Bartow's. This is another picture of that mill. This is one out in the country, was a smaller mill. This is Cook's Mill. This was down at the end of Lakeview Street in Montague. That was Cook owned the Ravenswood big house that they took down a few years ago. He planted a lot of the fields and stuff into peaches. New lumber was going to be gone, and he wanted to have a business of growing peaches. Here's Albert Anderson. That's an old family.
Up by the cockroach.
Cockroach and Grove, Alvin Anderson Jr. A lot of you probably remember him. There's the hotel. Now this is, this corner right here is where the Ripley building is. That's when it, the Montague House had burned, the big hotel there.
That's the Franklin House.
Franklin House, yeah.
And when was that built?
1874. Okay, 1874. Thank you, Kurt. Here's the M.D. Koval Mill in Whitehall. This is up at...
the Trading Post.
Trading Post, yes.
There were quite a few buildings there.
It was quite a, you know, settlement, Indian settlement at first.
Where is that located?
Down on the river at far end of Fruitvale, if you look east.
Where the canoe livery is now.
To the river, that's where it was.
It's a canoe takeout now.
This is
not where the livery is.
No, it's down on, if you go east on Fruitvale Road and keep going straight through the stop sign down to the river. This was, this bridge was up there.
Yep.
And they made a crossing there and threw mail over to the White House.
Well, that was the stagecoach route. And then when they built the Rochdale Inn, the cheapest way to get the lumber up there was to get rid of the bridge. And they dynamited. And man, and then, go ahead.
Well, they run the boats up there too with people.
Yeah.
Thank you. Clyde Price, if any of you remember him, he run one of those boats. This is the old mill up there at Rochdale. George Fernbank had it run it for years.
Yeah,
there.
He run it for the Continental
engine.
Here's a road crew that's leaving Montague.
They put in stone roads.
There's the hotel, and there's the, what was Nesbitt's sweet store. There's another, this livery stable here on the corner. Down in the, behind this, they had a barn where they kept the horses. They'd bring them up and hook them up, and then you'd come out these front doors.
They had two apartments upstairs in that building.
This was Dowling's boarding house. It's up on, was on top of the hill, mind you, where the big White House is now. That's the Montague Hotel. That was where the Ripley Lipka building is.
And that burned about after 2.5 years after it was built.
But it was really a fine hotel, I said.
Well, it would have to be. It had a separate entrance for the women.
This is the curtain roll. This would be down on the end of Knudsen Street, down below the hill. Just down below Henry Rossler. The curtain roll moved to Muskegon and then to Middlebury, Indiana.
It burnt down 3 times there and they didn't want to rebuild it. Barrels down the roof, not that much good.
Yeah. I'm talking about curtain rolls. It's the ones that your old shades rolled up on. This is on Dowling Street.
In legal horse racing.
Yeah, different guys would race their horses out there on certain days.
Another place they race their horses on the bottom of Franklin Hill to the cemetery.
This is the old fairgrounds out on the end of Wilcox and Whitbeck Road out there. You used to be able to see the track around there for years and years. The old fire barn downtown. And the library and the city offices.
And the jail.
And the jail. And the basement had the DPW truck in it.
Is that where the Weathervane Inn is now?
No.
This is up on Spring and Ferry Street.
Across from the post office.
Right, yeah.
No.
They tore it down.
Yeah. beta parking. There's Charlie Arnberger. He was the old one of the early chiefs. There's a Dowling's house that Ward Heaton has now on Sheridan Street.
Flowers Creek Inn.
This house, the whole house is one board laid on top of the other. There's no studs in it. It's solid.
When they went to wire, they had to put the wiring in the outside.
That's a Flower Creek Inn. If it was all around Flower Creek, you could stay there and eat. This is the Brocker's Mill at Flower Creek. They had milled grain and stuff.
Said it was one of the finest around here. People came from miles and miles just to have their grill. Right. There's a footing laying there yet in part of the dam.
This is a Lehman's Crate Works was out there in White River Township. The old Grange Hall, which was a real social meeting place for the people. There they're pulling stumps.
Many of the farmers paid their taxes by pulling the stumps out of the roadways, and that's how they paid their taxes.
That's the old lifeguard station down by you.
To be a lifeguard, you had to take a dip daily.
Which, you just had all those, that program down there is nice. That's somewhere. This fella right here is Ben Ailey, would be Ray's brother. That was Patty Coleman. Now, I've always been confused on this. Is the channel in there now, or isn't it?
Yeah, it's in front of the black hole.
Is it? There's the ferry that run across between Low Road and Murray's.
He used to charge 10 cents a person, and he used to say a lot of people didn't know it, that I could hear the kids in the trunk.
There's the Goodrich boats that came in here and brought a lot of our Illinois people here forever. This is down at the coal dock. Not here. There's another one at the coal dock.
The silt got so bad on our end of the lake that they couldn't turn anymore. So they made this a Goodrich dock.
They used to come down and stop the Whitehall dock, but yeah, well, same problem they're having today, they had them.
Well, they stopped at Montague Dock, too. Mm-hmm.
I don't know, this is when Pack, when they were going to have the big speedboat regatta in the area. They built all these grandstands along there.
And then the paper said there were going to be so many people didn't come.
This is where the boat docked in, down in the
Lakeside Inn.
And some of that lumber is still around.
That dock got covered. The sand dune kept bringing sand over and covered.
This was the old first store in Montague that was built by Dowling. And then Mason's had it. George Mason's folks, the old postmaster, and then...
Believe it or not, the farmers used to bring their wagons of hay in on the way up there, and yeah. That's how they sold them.
There's a scale right here.
Hey, Jack, that used to be Samuel Lazley's store. The guy in the far right, number four, is Samuel Lazley.
Yeah, I think so.
Built Roger, or owned Roger Charmer's house. Yeah. And number two on the left, with his knee on the step, is George Dowling, and Anna Dowling's in the dress.
Where was that store located?
Right down. Well,
it's still there.
It's still there.
Oh, yeah.
It's falling apart. I think they condemned it.
Well, where is it?
Right on the bottom of the Dowling and Ferry Street. Right there. Right across from there, it's a...
Nesbitt's, yep.
Here they're weighing hay, and you can see...
Any of you remember Adolf Anderson and Nels Michelson, Bill Barr, and Howard Durham? That Howard was a different uncle of Howard that was electrician. There's old Bill Sweet in his store. And they were once some of the first that recycled. When you went in and got your groceries, they brought them and set them on the counter, added them all up on the grocery bag. That was your receipt. And then you took it home, and there was no plastic in those days. There's
Fred Sweet's delivery.
Yeah, delivery. Sweet store, Topsy. That's
that was to lift the boats out of the water when they repaired the propellers on the...
This here thing was right down in the slip there. It's be on land probably now.
One was Johnson and the other one was...
Yeah, Johnson's Boat Works and stuff.
There was another guy. Montague train depot. And there's quite a few, it's hard to say.
There's the creamery, and later it was an ice house, and it was right behind Montague Foods on Spring Street down there.
Yeah.
That hadn't blacktopped the road yet in these days.
Well, the buildings over here was the Observer in the later days.
Yeah.
And quite like Gospel Center.
Gospel Center right
and
there.
Right behind that three thing light was a Johnson.
Axel Johnson.
Harness shop.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't the Observer office also used as the dive center?
Yes, later on. But it was a Gospel Center for years.
Did that Axel Johnson, did that become the barber shop?
I don't know.
Yes. Okay. Joe's Barber Shop.
Joe the Barber?
Yeah.
With an electrical shop, too, at one time.
Just be careful what you say about Axel today. This is paving Montague, the main street. Here's a hotel right there. This was where the senior center and professional building is. That was the post office at that time. This is the grist mill. That's where the theater was and the post office is today. Here's the fire barn. And then on up the street, Rantham's building.
On top of the fire station.
I think that's in the basement of the museum.
Oh, is it?
Mm-hmm. Well, that was down the shirt stage. When they took it down, they dropped and broke it.
That guy right there tending the boiler to do this is Leo Krupp. He told me a lot of stuff about these things. He pretty much worked on boilers most of his life, down at the foundry and on the boats. Now this, there's a livery stable right in here, more stores. So you can see the end now of the big building, then this drop down, then this is where the
Todd's
Pharmacy in Embuknook is now. This is the post office when they're working on that. That's my Uncle Clay and a Matson lady. Bill Ford was one of the old post office guys. There's another early care town hall.
One of the little signs there says Studebaker. So, and Studebaker made wooden wagons.
Yep.
Here's a livery stable, the other hotel, directly blocked. This is Ornberger's before it burned in 1920. 29, I think, 30.
What kind of business was that?
Was it a tavern?
Tavern.
Hotel?
Hardware.
And the hardware. And when it burned down, everyone was waiting for the dynamite to explode.
This was the Montague Inn, and later, that's right where the Weatherman is. See, they haven't had street, Roger Sharmer was here and planted all his trees down. This is looking the other way down Ferry Street. That's the, was the church place, and this is Inslee's livery stable there. The Lex Chisholm, if any of you remember, he wrote for the Chronicle. This was at Chisholm Store, which is where the Hallmark apartments are on Dowling Street, if you want to go down.
Town Council.
Well, I wouldn't say it's the Town Council. But if any of you go downtown Montague in the summer, the same guys are sitting in front of the book now. This was Banks' livery stable. This was a house down there.
When that burned, Whitehall and Montague both went over there. They couldn't get enough water, so they drove one of the trucks down into the lake. And then when they knew it was gone, Whitehall and Montague used to cool the other side off down there. But they couldn't get the truck back up, and they had to get a winch.
Those steps are still there, sort of.
Sort of, yeah. Let's go back. You can see all the terraces. There's other pictures that really have good. The terraces, now Carlos Michelson told me this, that his dad or grandfather helped grade all that with his team and stuff, but he never got paid. There's the old one of the King buses coming across the bridge.
That was a neat bridge. I've never heard of King buses.
Well, the King boys, Grant and Jerry, all us, their grandpa and dad and uncle and them bought out the livery business. When cars came in, they run taxi service. And then they got these buses and run when they up to Rochdale.
Yeah, you got Rochdale up there. They also transport the people from the Rochdale to Blue Lake. Yeah.
First snow plows were run by the Greyhound lines.
Marv tells about his dad going down the ball and out the Greyhound. Greyhounds, like they do today, they very trophy fab. One of the plows threw the snow up and broke the window out of their truck. He drove right down the bridge.
There's the Rochdale Inn.
And that's a modification.
This is, this is in Whitehall. And yeah. I think it's right where the pizza place is on the corner along in there. Is that right, Norm?
I think so.
There's some more of it. Looking over to the Montague side there.
That Coliseum thing was the movie in the skate place in Whitehall. And you can see Carpenter Chevrolet on M11 that hasn't been in there yet.
There's looking west of
the Ford Garage would be on this side.
Right in here.
That was a plumbing shop, but there was a wooden mill in there, and when it burned it down, they built that.
Was that the hotel right
That's
there?
That's Mears Hotel.
This is the Whitehall Dock. During the early days, when a lot of people what happened after the logging industry went out, we had a lot of big old homes and stuff, boarding houses on the lake, so those were basically turned into hotels. Summer people.
Resorts.
And they came up and the roads weren't good, so there was a lot of these launches that run just around the lake daily. You just went out on your dock and waved your flag and they stopped, picked you up, and you could come to Montague, Whitehall, and Murray's, or wherever you wanted to go.
I think the green flag means you wanted to come up lake, and a red flag if you wanted to go down lake.
This evidently is taken from the tanner, yeah.
And there's a quarter for a round trip for 15 cents for one way.
This is looking down.
Where the city disposal was.
Yeah.
That's when the railroad station was down below the playhouse. And that's Hyde Park when they're putting the big chimney up.
There's the man of the hour, Axel Johnson. He was harness maker, fixed shoes, harness, and then went into the hardware business. That's down on the end of Ferry Street. It's gone now, it's right where the apartments are.
There's a story that says Mr. Pickton and them talked him into coming out of Chicago because there wasn't any good harness makers here.
This is another hardware store, buddy.
What was the XXX on the signs in the one before that?
Question, you have a question?
Axel, he evidently got a good deal on trunks.
Someone back there had a question. On the sign, there's three X's in a previous picture. He wanted to know if you knew what that was.
Coffee. One more back.
One more back. Oh, back. It says coffee, but it's got XXX.
Oh, yeah, to the left. The sign there. It's four X's.
Four X's.
It's coffee.
It's strong coffee.
Maybe like four stars.
Here's another one of the hardware stores. This was Ornberger's, I think.
How many hardware stores did they have?
Well, they kept coming and going. People kept adding things. If you look back, I think this one. See, there's a radio in here now. We're moving along.
If you went into Ripley's drugstore and the Detroit Lions and the Tigers were playing, you just will go home because he wouldn't fill your prescriptions because he didn't
Look at all the new lawnmowers here. Some of us pushed some of them. That was my Uncle Marv had a trucking route from here to Muskegon. He hauled cream and milk into a sanitary dairy. Then they stacked all the cans on one truck and they hauled groceries back, stopping in Dalton, Montague, Whitehall, and as far as New Era. This is the Cook Street Bridge.
They tore it down, partly. But the school bus couldn't go across it anymore. And they went out there and took the ports out of the bridge and dumped and filled it in with sand and then that took the next port. And the bridge is still under there.
This is, you're looking north here on Cook Street. Buttermilk Creek.
Yeah.
Now if you look back in here, you see that tower? That used to be down below the hill. Then George Dowling moved it up here. He was going to make all this thing into a park. There was a dam down in here. There's that tower up there. When Lyson Rings bought it, before they built the big house that's there now, they lived in this. Now this is taken from that tower. Pushing instead of talking. This is the Montague North Hill School, which got moved here in the late article. You look in here, so mine goes down here, the hotel down in there, you're looking right down the gully. This was Rutledge's Cider Mill. This was the Holland Church that was up on the corner of Dicey and Stanton.
Okay. What kind of church was that?
New Holland.
Holland Church, Dutch Church.
That's gone.
The house is made right there, made out of the bricks and stuff.
The man bought it and tore it down, made the bricks and made a house. And some of the neighbors made fireplace.
But this school didn't work out. I don't know why they ever built it, but they used it for a number of years for a knitting mill. This is Ferry Street looking up. That house up on top there is still there. This is probably from about Hunt Street, or maybe a little further north, up on North Ferry Street. That's a Catalpa's Resort. It was down Maple Grove and Broadbeck, and a lot of summer people. This is the little store that was right there, and Broadbeck had a store. This was Flaxton's Grocery down in Maple Grove, which was bent right in by Aunt Dolly's.
So yeah, right next door.
Right next door, yeah. This is the Hill Place down in Maple Grove. It'd be kind of where the Cook Street and Anderson Road and Old Channel are all on that corner there. That's the Maple Grove School.
Montague High School superintendent office. I got kids hanging on those trees and on that fence. And everyone wonders why these kids ain't got shoes on. Well, a pair of shoes back then was a day's wages.
This building, they cut right down here and cut it in half. And it's down, still exists down in Ravenswood on that property. They made a couple of houses out of it. I forgot now. I think that the Mount School, I think. Yeah, this was.
Do you notice the two doors there? Well, the girls went in one and the boys went in the other, so the boys been saying, I'd see London when the crew was getting undressed.
This is the Mirror School. This was out on the corner of Oaks and Troopdale. And I was at Taft Nesbitt's one night showing him, and his brother Bob was there. He stood up and walked up and he says, that's me right there. I think that was, he pointed one of them. He talked about his, the teacher in the school. That's the Montague School.
Where was the Montague School?
Right where the early school is now.
It was facing?
Faced.
The other street.
Yeah, Grant Street. This was the one on the North Hill.
There's their Montague's
school buses.
School buses. And you got in and out the back.
Yes. Have benches along the sides.
Summer school out.
Well, let's see. Lamus and Minor Park.
Minor Park.
Those two schools, Montague, Mr. Early was one of the first that had portable classrooms. When those two schools, when they quit using them, they Hunts hauled them in and set them up on William Street. Do you remember it?
I do.
Yeah. And they used them for portable classrooms.
Why did they go to summer school back then?
I don't think it was summer school. It was Flower Creek School. That was later built into a brick building. Early days.
We have in the Montague Museum
is Bill Flaxton, that'd be Chuck Flaxton's uncle. That was my Uncle Marv and Henry Nolman. This is when the Montague High School burned. This is down on Knudsen Street. This is the Ferry Memorial Church right here. The high school went there, great kids went to a Methodist church. This good looking guy's my dad. Pinky Gesell, Harry Fernbank. Let's see. That's Happy Crawl, Frank Crawl. I forget that. That's what I reflected. There's Dolly's boat. That was one around the lake. Here's the, this is a slip in Montague. Here's a sling where they.
But that's the other, I don't think that's Johnson's. There were two men down there.
No.
Johnson.
They were down there, yeah. This is in, there's that sling right there again. This is right up in the parking lot almost at the Weather Vane Inn.
Is that sling to put propellers on?
Yeah.
Yeah, and repair.
Yeah.
This boat came to back and forth from Muskegon once a day before the railroad.
This is another picture in the Montague slip. So you can see how many launches were, some of them were private, but most of them were running around the lake. Here's another.
You look right
there. Now, look right there. That goes right under the road. That's where they used to bring the logs over to the mill. There's a little gazebo here.
And they closed that off. Montague lost their harbor down the silt.
And
Whitehall closed off the tube by Cobalt. That's when we lost the harbor in Whitehall.
Now this is right in the slip again. This was Boat Johnson's Boat Works right along the road to Whitehall. You can see Whitehall up there. There's another. There's a gazebo.
That was a trailer park in the softball park, right?
What?
The cleared lane.
The trailer park's over here.
Okay, I thought that was.
Well, no, they did have a park, baseball field down here. This was where White Lake Lumber was. There was a laundry in there.
Okay.
That's the Ornberger building. This was the Masonic lot. There's a Banks building, a hotel in the background. There's Charlie Ornberger and Bill Ornberger. This was before they remodeled the station down there. There's the crew again. That's Art Nichols, Bill Ornberger, Charlie Ornberger, and Tom Wonders. This after 46, because they'd done the road. Here's the White Lake Market Association. That's where the Montague City Hall is now. This was a big bandsaw that was, they built in the
Montague
foundry down here. The foundry was started up during the logging days to make pulleys and shivs and all that stuff for the sawmills. When the mills went out, then they went into making boat engines. And then they went into the car parts and stuff later on. This is the Richardson. This is down, was down in the, well, you can see the, there's the livery box, the barn. This is a later year of the gazebo down there. Sweets store. Rufus Hunt putting up ice. Back when they cut all the ice out of the lake and stored it. delivered it to the houses and the stores. This is an earlier one where they're cutting on the lake.
They can only cut partway through so they could come back and cut the other way, and the guy come along, there it is, and the guy come along with a handsaw and cut them the rest of the way.
This Rufus, I bought this, then he sold it to the Grover Fisheries, and then they used it, and it's in the museum now downstairs there.
With the handsaw?
Yeah. This is the old ironworks, the early days.
There's the horse trough. Mm-hmm.
This is another view, there was a lot of different. This, Laura? That house was moved up on the corner of Dicey and Stanton.
That's where Montague Foods used to be, that whole block area there.
Yeah. That's a Shiloh house. That's in Zion, Illinois. That was Dowie's house. Here's one of the early buses. This is corner of Fruitvale. There's a
independent order of odd
fellows. Yeah. They're a lot.
They were up above was the bank.
They were upstairs here. And that little tough guy right there is Grandpa Lipka. A little later shot of the town where the weather vane is. And then this was Johnson's auto, and then later the Hobnob Dairy and
Stewart's.
And you can see the lumber yard in here now. This was
the Bull Factory. Bull White, and them were two of the boats that took the visitors up to Rochdale Inn, being in storage.
This the Standard Oil
Farm tank.
Yeah.
Right where the bowling alley is across the street.
There's the early milk.
Akabaka Dairy.
Akabaka Dairy, and that's the Ripley House down there. Then they got rid of the horse and got a truck.
What's that?
There is only about 10.
Don't you write your coffee?
Now would be a good time for you to take a break and stretch your limbs a little bit, maybe get some refreshments before we begin, and let these guys have a bit of a break too. Just a suggestion. 10 more? Jack said he's only got 10 more. We can drag it out. Just kidding.
This is right down on the corner down by the weather vane.
Well, that's
Ornberger's building in the back arm.
That's the right leg in.
Right leg in. It's right where the weather vane is today. This is Whitehall.
Whitehall just up from the Scoville Long Mill.
This is Pete Anderson's livery. That would be right about where the book nook is now. That was a whale back boat from
Christopher Columbus. That raced from Chicago to Milwaukee, trying to beat everyone else.
There's the Tannery Band. There's the inside of the Opera House.
Where was that?
That was right where the Montague City Hall is now.
It's burnt down.
Wow.
Well, that it's just.
That's it.
That's it. That was good talking.
A lot of members of the booming companies were the mills.
Yeah, it was owned by the mill people.
Sort of the cooperative.
Co-op, yeah.
And they got enough logs, they took them out into White Lake and they drove pigs and made a raft and then they took them to the different sawmills.
That one picture of the river, you could see all of what they called boomsticks. It was all like big square beams chained together, and they sorted them into different areas.
You see these little ends of the logs in the museum, and you see them other places. Well, that was what I sawed off your log and put my mark on. So,
those are getting harder to find.
So they started notching the side also, putting a mark on the side. So
they always think of ways around stuff, don't you?
Right after Nancy. Because I remember.
It's the kind of situation, and I'm not talking,